Welcome back to the inaugural Pepsi Red, White, and Blue Open presented by USBC. Time now for our title match, $25,000 and a one-season exemption on the line. There is Wayne Garber, the number two seed, who will start this one off on the bench as he takes on the reigning U.S. Open champ and the fourth seed, Mike Scroggins. Scroggins defeating Michael Fagan, 218-197, and then in the semis, dispatching number one seed Patrick Allen, 227-215. No simultaneous matches in this one, thankfully.
It was a little busy.
Yes, it was. Here's Wayne Garber. His best finish this season, Randy, 35th at the Viper Championship. Had a slew of 60s, 68, a 66, a 69 at the Shark Championship. Did not bowl at the PBA World Championship. And here he is, one win away from his first tour title, a big paycheck, and a season's exemption.
Well, Rob, most of the patterns that the players bowl on a weekly basis are very flat, meaning there's not a lot of help to the outside part of the lane and not a heavy buildup of oil in the middle. The red, white, and blue oil patterns are a little softer, or I should say a lot softer than what the guys are used to bowling on a weekly basis. And so what had happened was there was a lot more buildup in the middle part of the lane. That allows Wayne Garber to go straight, and that's his A game. Give him a little bit of hold, and he's going to strike a lot.
Garber struck a lot to get here. Here's a look at our bear breakdown. The two, Scroggins and Garber, similar in age. Huge discrepancy in TV finals, titles, and career earnings. $1.2 million to $74,000 for Garber. Talked about Garber coming back after having snapped both patella tendons. He said, boy, there were some depressing moments, guys. I woke up a few times just crying. Boy, he snaps that release, doesn't he?
Well, he's got angle, and when you have angle and you have a little bit of hold, it's easy to keep the ball in the 1-3 pocket. But a good release will also ensure you snapping that 10 out, and that was a good shot off his hand. Right now, he's just living the dream. Look how happy he is.
Holy kick on the 7. You need breaks like that to win titles.
Remember, his high game on the other pair, just to the left, was 227. And there's no way, I don't think, in this match that 227 is going to win. Right here, what a huge break. Working on a strike. The love tap on the 7 for the first double of the match.
Really slow start to the season for Scroggins. 72nd at the opening tournament, the Motor City Open, and then a pair of 20-mid-something finishes. Oh, yeah. Starting to get his groove on as the season progressed. This is his second top 10. He was 9th. At the PBA World Championships, which was held right here at North Rock Lanes in Wichita in late December. See Woody Austin in the red shirt back there, taking it all in. He's not missing any of the bowling. It's nice of him to join us.
It really was.
Earlier today. Nice guy.
I can cross that off of my bucket list.
There you go. Wayne Garber trying to cross one off his bucket list. That would be a PBA Tour title. He said it's a boyhood dream to win one. Jacks for Garber. Making the TV finals has been a lifelong dream for Wayne, but it was a dream he was pretty sure would never be realized after the injury.
No, I'd long since given up on my PBA dream more than once. Getting through the RPI tournament and becoming exempt, that was surreal, unbelievable, and this is right up there as well. I always believed in myself that if I had, you know, a look that I knew I could hit, that this day was possible. But I didn't think I'd ever see it.
Boy, and he wanted that one. It was a good shot, too, but a vicious ringing 10 where the 6 just kind of goes right around that 10 pin. He was looking for that one to tie up the match.
Garber grew up emulating Steve Cook, another big guy, also another California resident.
Well, Steve Cook's a Hall of Famer, a southpaw, big high backswing, big man, but well, I'll tell you what, that's a great style to emulate. There weren't too many on this tour that ever threw it better than Steve Cook.
So Garber stays clean through his first four frames. Down 11, though, to Mike Scroggins. The conclusion of the Pepsi Red, White, and Blue Open presented by USBC when ESPN's coverage returns to Wichita. Mike Scroggins, perfect through three with an early lead.